Hello, Derby Sisters from Dallas. I'm Elba McPherson. I'm a retired skater, bench coach, and now a volunteer with the Des Moines Derby Dames. Roller derby is very near and dear to my heart, and as a former Dallas resident and someone who skated very briefly with Assassination City, I can tell you that I am so excited to be your team wrangler at the upcoming Division II playoffs in August.
Hey Omaha, most of you already know me, but my name is Malai, and I'm the founder of the Des Moines Derby Dames, and we are super excited to have you guys at our tournament. I will be your wrangler for the weekend. So call me, text me at any time. I will be there when you're practicing, when you're playing, whatever you guys need, I'm your woman.
Are you tired of slipping through slippery corners? Fed up with slipping on slippery surfaces? Introducing the villain from Radar Wheels. Stride confidently through corners without slipping out. The villain digs and holds through the corners like no other. Grips on even the worst surfaces. But don't take our word for it.
I hate sliding out. The villains were so grippy, I felt like I was totally in control. The wheels are really grippy. They were really grippy, but they were still so fast.
Skater approved. The Villain and Villain Wide by Radar Wheels. Order now!
And we're on. Hello, Woofed.tv. I'm Stunt Rocker.
I am Bulldog.
I have trouble looking at myself.
All right, we are getting ready to watch the next. We're going to see who is moving into the fifth place game right now. Dallas versus Omaha. These teams are playing to move into the fifth place bracket. The loser, of course, will move into the seventh place bracket. What do you think, Stun Rocker?
I think we're in for a really good game. I think these are two pretty evenly matched teams. They're both coming off of rebuilding years. They both had some pretty significant retirements and losses. And I think they're both. It's anybody's game to be taken right now.
Oh, indeed. Okay, we're going to start out with a little roster list. Omaha Roller Girls are fielding number 101, Sharon Misery. Number 1303, Forbidden Fruit. Number 2, McKillia. Number 26, Texas Viper. Number 3, Home Sweet Homes. Number 39, Midlife Crashes. Number 402, Make It Rain. Number 42, Axel Rogue. Number 665, Daisy Mayhem. Number 6 foot, Danielle in your coffin. Number 777, Rady Ruck. I am pronouncing it correctly, Rady Ruck. Number G30, Skateaway Faye. Number L3, Dire Skates. And MK80, Molly Massacre. That's the Omaha roster.
And for the Dallas Derby Devils Army of Darkness, you've got number 9, Chemical Addiction, Mary Kate. Number 1, Mary 8, Ashley. Number 1,000, Electra Violet. Number 11, Lickety Split Tail. Number 12, 29, Juice Box. 13, Brandy Danger. 138, Anita Riot. Number 20, Punchy Bruiser. Number 41, Postal Penny. Number 4, NR, EM Urgency. Number 666, Weapon X. Number 8, Rhinestone Callgirl. Number B, 200, Rosemary Rockets, and H2O, The Little Murder Maid.
And starting off, we have Anita Riott jamming for Dallas in the black. And in the green, Omaha's Rady Ruck has claimed lead jammer. Anita Riott knocked out, not to the infield, but manages to keep from going back in bounds. Makes a split run between Texas Viper and Daisy Mayhem. Gets out of the pack, but Rady Ruck now on her first scoring pass. At the back of the pack, Dallas holding her far back. Now Weapon X with a shoulder check, but Rady Ruck able to get past her. Calls off the jam, but looks like Anita Riott may have clinched. No, doesn't quite get in there. Rady Ruck called it off just in time. 4-0 Omaha after the first jam.
What we're looking at there is Omaha really left that a big gap there right between Daisy Mayhem and Vicious Vixen. Or I don't get that name wrong.
Texas Viper?
Texas Viper. I don't know where my mouth just jumped out of my head.
It's all right. Well, next jam, we got a make hit rain, number 402. Gets a big shoulder check from Juice Box of Dallas, but Juice Box stepped out of bounds a little bit. She was able to come back in and did get the legal pass. Oh, no, excuse me. It wasn't a step out. It was actually Juice Box getting a looking for this. Oh, she got sent to the penalty box. Also joined by Mary 8 Ashley. So Dallas down two blockers already in the second jam.
Juicebox coming in with a jam skating background, giving her a lot of agility in the pack.
3 points for Make It Rain in the second jam. Dallas has already got two blockers in the box. All right, and we're moving into jam number three. Weapon X, number 666, for jamming for Dallas. And number 39, Axel Rogue, jamming for Omaha. It's a 4-on-2 pack advantage, and Postal Penny tries to connect with Axel Rogue, but Axel Rogue able, no, excuse me, Midlife Crashes. That was 39, not 29. Sorry. I'm obviously still got a little bit more warming up to do. Midlife Crashes knocked out. She's on a scoring pass. Postal Penny this time making the connection, but Midlife Crashes skating up the inside lane, getting past Electra Violet. That's a Dallas blocker, and now Weapon X still on her initial pass. Daisy Mayhem makes connection, and Texas Viper follows that up. Weapon X knocked out, and there goes Midlife Crashes, another scoring pass, a grand slam for Omaha. That's going to be a 10-point jam for Midlife Crashes of Omaha, and Dallas yet to get on the board.
Midlife Crashes, we're number 39, no longer her age, which was her age, but she recently celebrated her 40th birthday, it out there for all of us older people, setting a great example.
She's been in the sport how long, and that's still not her age?
2 years. Midlife Crashes was just brought up from the B team as well, the Omaha Triple A, as they call it, for this D2 tournament.
All right, a rematch from jam number one, Rady Ruck, number 777 for Omaha, against Anita Riott, number 138 for Dallas. Rady Ruck up front. She's getting a pounding from Chemical Addiction, but able to get up the inside and lead jammer once again for Omaha. Omaha so far dominating the on the jammer line. Dallas, as you can see from the score, has yet to put a point on the board, but Anita Riott getting out of the pack and racing around. Rady Ruck moves in, gets past Juice Box, shuffled off out of bounds by that is Lickety Split Tail, but calls it off, and once again Dallas coming up empty. 3 points Omaha.
These Omaha jammers are really just taking advantage of some pretty big holes in the line for the Dallas Derby Devils. Just splitting the pack, getting through, grabbing their 4 points and calling it.
That's right, Omaha looking very strong early in the game. Only 5 minutes in, though, so Dallas may just be getting warmed up, just like me. Chemical Addiction in the penalty box for Dallas, and Molly Massacre for Omaha. So 3-on-3 in the pack. We got Rhinestone Call Girl, number 8 for Dallas, jamming for the first time. Once again, Dallas in the black, Omaha in the green. And for Dallas, it's Skate Away Faye, G30, jamming, and she picks up lead jammer 4 times in a row for Omaha. Dallas has yet to pick up a single lead jammer. Rhinestone Call Girl finds that inside lane. Follows Skate Away Faye right through the pack, but Skate Away Faye was on a scoring pass, a full lap ahead of the Dallas jammer. It's a grand slam for Omaha, and once again, Dallas shut out.
And that's going to take the score to 25 for Dallas, and or for Omaha, and 0 for Dallas. All Omaha in their olive jerseys and Dallas in the black. We'd also like to make sure that you stop by and check out the Cheese Balls Bearings Bracket Bonanza. Fill it out for all of the D2, the remaining D2 tournament in Kalamazoo, and the ones in the following D1 tournaments.
And a fresh jammer for Dallas, number 1229, Juice Box, going up against number 402, Make It Rain. The Little Murder Maid, number H20. Looks like she got a penalty, a high block against Make It Rain, and that means it's going to be a 4-on-2 pack for Omaha. Once again, Make It Rain on a scoring pass, gets around Punchy Brewster, number 2020. Now Rosemary Raucus double shoulder checks, and Make It Rain stopped in her tracks, calls off the jam.
Axel Rogue trying to come out of that set offense for the power jam, trying to push away the jam, make a hole for Make It Rain there. She didn't quite get it opened up, but Make It Rain made it through anyway.
That's right. Very aggressive jamming from Omaha. They have really been, I mean, the jammers have been making their own holes. I mean, not to take away credit from the blockers are doing a fantastic job for Omaha, but I like to see jammers who are not afraid to block. And here we go, number 39, Midlife Crashes, just as you said, just brought up from the B team, but a shining star so far this weekend for Omaha. Knocked out of bounds by Brandy Danger, number 13 for Dallas. And there goes Electro Violet, number 1,000, to the penalty box. So that is the Dallas running into serious penalty trouble. Only 7 jams in. I think they've gotten more than 1 penalty per jam. Omaha has only 1 penalty so far. So Midlife Crash is coming around on a scoring pass. They're on a power jam. That is Juice Box in the penalty box as well. Dallas with a full box. So Rosemary Raucus and Brandy Danger. Brandy Danger inverted, leaning into Midlife Crashes, trying to hold her back. Midlife Crashes just relentless, though. That nice job of slowing down the Omaha jammer, keep limiting her scoring passes, but Midlife Crashes calling off the jam.
Midlife Crashes doing a great job there, staying in the middle of the track during the power jam, not getting towards one edge or the other where she could be in danger of going out and being backed up. Just staying in the middle, moving back and forth within that middle zone, really, really working that offense.
All right, now Dallas, we forgot to mention, Dallas came in seated number 9. Omaha came in seated number 7. So both teams have the opportunity here to improve their initial seeding. Omaha, if they can win this, they can potentially come out as high as 5th. But Dallas, no matter what, they're guaranteed to come out ahead of their seeding. They were seeded at number 9. They can come in no less than 6th place.
And that's really going to help them. They came into this Dallas overall, into this tournament on short notice, seeded at number 63. But because of the dropouts higher up in the tournament's schedule, they were able to move into the Division II tournament.
Okay. Sorry, I misspoke. The loser of this bout goes on to the 7th place, and so Dallas can finish no less than 8th place. Excuse me. However, Omaha, if they were to lose this game, which right now they are coming on strong, although Dallas did just get on the board, 34-4 now. But Omaha, if they lose this game, then they will go into the 7th place bout and an opportunity to defend their initial seeding. But right now they are coming on strong in the first half. 9 jams in, 34 points for Omaha, and Dallas finally getting on the board. And definitely Dallas getting into a lot of early penalty trouble.
Dallas has all of their jammers are pretty fresh. They're all with less than 2 years of experience in Derby, and they keep them on a pretty strict schedule or rotation. The last time around, all of the jammers had 12 jams except for one who had 13, odd number of jams in the game. But they really just stick to their rotation, very, very disciplined in that.
And look at Weapon X weaving around Molly Masker and gets past Daisy Mayhem, completing her initial pass. But she is a half a lap still behind Skateaway Faye, the Omaha jammer. And once again, Omaha lead jammer calls off the jam. Grand slam for Skateaway Faye. And Weapon X just coming up short for Dallas.
Weapon X comes true to her, the name she's named after being named after the comic book character Wolverine. She has a hockey background, so Canadians hockey.
Well, you know, you can see it kind of in her style. She has a really good side-to-side motion. That's very common when you see someone from a skater background. You know, just really agile. I think Quadzilla, I don't know if you know who that is, but
I think most people know Quadzilla.
But he calls it East-West. You got to be a North-South and an East-West skater. You can't just be North-South or East-West. You know,
Absolutely. Speed
skaters tend to be North-South. Hockey players tend to be East-West. You got to go everywhere. But there's Anita Riot breaking out, and I believe, unless I missed something, I believe that is the first time that Dallas has gotten lead jammer.
I think they may have gotten the very first one.
That's
Anita
right.
Anita Riot.
Yeah, it's possible when I was drawn away about the seedings and the potential final rankings for these teams that I might have missed. I wasn't paying close attention to that jam, I'm afraid. But Anita Riot has got a grand slam for Dallas through there. Make It Rain struggling to get out. Oh, Juice Box with a shoulder check knocks down Make It Rain. Make It Rain struggling to even penetrate into the pack now. Postal Penny and Mary 8 Ashley with a two wall at the back. Electra Violet backing them up, and Anita Riot comes through a second time. Makilia whiffing with a shoulder check, and Anita Riot gets another grand slam. 10 points for Dallas after a complete dry spell. Now there, it looks like Anita Riot putting some fire into the Dallas team. And look at that, Make It Rain going to the penalty box. This is their first power jam for Dallas. Huge opportunity for Anita Riot. Makilia can't stop her. And Sharon Misery sent to the penalty box. Free ride for Anita Riot. And it's now up to 15 points in this jam.
She's got to deal with Omaha's going to have to deal with a short pack on this.
That's right. It's a 4-on-3 pack advantage. Omaha's Axel Rowe coming in with a vicious shoulder check that sent Anita Riot reeling, but she pops right back in, comes in clean, and that's a 20-point jam. And Dallas making up this deficit with a vengeance. One power jam, and they are right back in this game. Anita Riot going back and forth. Makilia is showing some excellent positional blocking, and Anita Riot not even able to make a single point. That would have been a 3-point pass if she had been able to get past any one of those blockers. But you know what? 20-point jam. I think she's happy with that.
Yes, I think there's nothing to complain about with that. Makilia, of course, there making that last stop. Was not available for the game yesterday. The games Omaha played yesterday. She's stuck working, so she's been a real asset. She was a real benefit to them against DC.
Weapon X jamming now on the tail end of a power jam. Make It Rain for Omaha. Still sitting in the penalty box. Dallas in the black. Omaha in the green, in case you're just joining us. And, Weapon X getting a cutting the track, and that's going to release the Omaha jammer, Make It Rain, number 402. Look at Brandy Danger and Rosemary Raucus extending that bridge all the way to the top of turn four. Make It Rain had to recycle all the way back there just to get in, and she is now on her initial pass. Dallas instantly taking control of the front of the pack. Rosemary Raucus, the little murder maid, and Brandy Danger. Brandy Danger leaning that shoulder and just an immovable object for Make It Rain, and little murder maid coming in to help her out. A fierce battle at the front of the pack. Make It Rain, though, finally getting the free pass from the referees, gets lead jammer, and she's had enough. She called it off. No points for Omaha.
It's interesting there was a fierce battle going on at the front of the pack with the jammer, and then back at the back of the pack, Daisy Mayhem and Sharon Misery had a goat in the back holding that person back to control the pack. There was a fierce battle going on at the back of the pack as well.
That's right. Now they play the entire depth and breadth of the pack. This is both of these teams playing very aggressively. I love a good aggressive game of roller derby. Midlife Crash is now jamming, number 39 for Omaha. Runs into Emergency and Postal Penny, number 41 for Dallas. It's Emergency and Postal Penny are two different people. Emergency, I believe, is 4NR. Yeah, sometimes they have letters in their numbers, which technically in ASCII, they're all letters are numbers as well as numbers.
This is true.
But that's a computer geek joke. Anyway, we got Midlife Crashes fighting at the front of the pack, but Electra Violet knocking her to the outside. She has to recycle. Weapon X released from the penalty box. She was serving a shortened penalty. after Make It Rain, because Make It Rain was already in there when she was sent. And she gets out Notley Jammer. That is Midlife Crashes just on one foot, holding on after a big shoulder check from Emergency. And she's going to get settled for 4 points in that jam.
Midnight Nothing Crash is just showing a lot of really savvy play today. Between that move and then earlier in the jam where she got knocked out, slid in, and then crawled back out to avoid cutting the track penalty. She's just really shown herself to be a real asset to this team. I'm sure they're very glad they brought her up.
That's right. Yeah, she's performing very well today, this weekend, in fact. Rady Ruck, number 777, looking for the inside lane. It looks like Rosemary Raucus and Mary 8 Ashley are there with a two-wall. But she gets, and it's an out of play on Mary 8 Ashley as well. But look at that, Texas Viper going to the penalty box. So both teams down a block. And now Lickety Splittail, number 11, going to the penalty box for Dallas as well. So it's going to be a three-on-two pack. Rady Ruck through the pack on her first scoring pass with a grand slam. And Rhinestone Callgirl, number 8, the jammer for Dallas, completing her initial pass. So a full lap. And then about a quarter, Rady Ruck actually opening up a little bit more of a lead as she hits the pack. Two-wall in the front. Chemical Addiction and Rosemary Raucus knocking her out of bounds. And she gets a back block, and that sends her to the box. Rhinestone Callgirl now on the power jam, but running into some trouble with Daisy Mayhem and Molly Massacre.
That is a formidable two-wall. Rady Ruck was trying to call the jam, actually, as she went into that block. As she fell from after that back block, she committed.
Daisy Mayhem sent to the penalty box, but a full penalty box for Omaha sends her right back in. So she has a stacked penalty for the ladies in green. And Dallas's Rhinestone Callgirl, number 8, through the pack and another grand slam.
Dodges that truck and trailer they were doing, that Molly Massacre and Daisy Mayhem were trying to do right there.
Now Texas Viper coming out of the penalty box, and that opens up a seat for Daisy Mayhem. She goes straight in, so still only two blockers on the track. Dallas at full strength, another grand slam, and they are in shooting distance. Only a few seconds left in the jam, but Rhinestone Callgirl, if she is quick, she could potentially tie it up, but only going to get 4 points on that pass. Actually, she could potentially pull into the lead. Rhinestone Callgirl, this is it. Last seconds of the jam, runs into Texas Viper, and not going to get any points for Omaha. Points.
I think that was because she slid out of bounds as she was passing.
Waiting for the point. I don't know that. Oh, okay. Only 3 points on that pass. Not quite enough, but it's a 2-point game. Would you have thought this after the first four jams? it was looking like it was just going to be an Omaha runaway, but now Dallas right back in it. 2-point game.
Dallas calmed themselves down and got back into it. We'd also like to thank some of our sponsors. Rydell Skates, rydellskates.com. Rydell, the official skate of WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. They will be giving the tournament MVP spot. They are also the tournament MVP sponsors. Derby for All and Rydell. MVPs will receive a package including Rydell 495s. I want that.
The MVP.
It's a free skate. Adam Wheels, also a wonderful sponsor of the WFTDA. Proud partner in the official wheel of the WFTDA.
All right, we've got Dallas has two blockers in the penalty box. It's Chemical Addiction and Mary 8 Ashley. Daisy Mayhem for Omaha in the penalty box also, so 3-on-2 pack. But Skate Away Faye chugging away with lead jammer status. Anita Riot still in the pack, facing a three-wall of Omaha blockers. Makilia on the outside, weaving her way back and forth, and Axel Rogue on point for Omaha. And it's just Skate Away Faye breezes through the pack untouched. An easy grand slam for Omaha.
Kind of earning her nickname, Skate Away Faye.
Indeed. And she's just chugging it. One of the, I don't think it's rude to point this out, but one of the smallest skaters on the track, possibly on, at all for both teams. But look at her go. Running into Brandi Danger. Brandi Danger able to muscle her out of bounds. That's one of the few places where size is a disadvantage when you've got that direct contact and you're leaning into each other. Yeah, the person that's bigger is going to have the advantage.
Usually, but unless the shorter person can get under the center of gravity and somehow pop them up, yeah, that bigger that mass usually helps. And Omaha is they're a tall team. Not hard to say. They are a team of tall, hard-hitting women. And Skate Away Faye, kind of the runt of the litter.
I think there's a lot of corn in Omaha. All right, we got but not as much in Dallas, but you know what? They are chugging away, too. We got Weapon X, number 666, at the back behind a four wall. Omaha now at full strength. Make it rain, though. Number 402 for Omaha is lead jammer. Omaha wearing the green jerseys and Dallas in the black jerseys. Weapon X around the outside, ducks under a shoulder check from Molly Massacre, but Texas Viper able to get ahead of her, and Molly Massacre recovers her position. There goes Make It Rain up the inside, sneaky move, and gets her a grand slam. Oh, that was a juice box just flying over Sharon Misery at the back of the pack. I don't know. I'm not sure if you caught that on the feed, but there's Weapon X up at the front. Texas Viper with a shoulder check drives her out of bounds, and she comes back in at the back. Make It Rain on another scoring pass. She's behind Chemical Addiction, Mary 8 Ashley, both freshly returned from the penalty box, and Juice Box rounding it out with a four wall. And Rosemary Raucus on the inside trying to catch Make It Rain, but she's cut off by Texas Viper at the front of the pack.
Rosemary Raucus had an excellent game yesterday. She was just a beast against Tallahassee.
Absolutely, and she's showing it here. She's, you know, she's about half the size of Daisy Mayhem, but she just comes right at her with a shoulder check. She is playing an absolutely fearless game right now. But Weapon X, gets knocked down. It looks like it was a cutting the track. I saw a penalty was called, and it looks like someone got a cutting the track. Waiting to see who reports to the penalty box. May have been, it looks like Daisy Mayhem for Omaha going to the penalty box. That means Omaha will be down a blocker before on three pack advantage for Dallas.
I believe that was actually a back block penalty.
I was looking at the signal, but sometimes they get adjusted.
We are looking at a team timeout right now for Dallas. Of course, you can always see when a team timeout, what kind of timeout is going on right underneath the Wufta.tv symbol on your screen. Dallas still staying out there during their, or Omaha staying out there during the team timeout, and out there in the olive jerseys, the Dallas Derby Devils, Army of Darkness, out there in the black jerseys, appropriate to that name.
Well, I guess olive is a kind of green.
It is.
Yeah.
Like the leaves of corn?
I think olive is more accurate than green, but, you know.
I think they grow a lot of olives in Nebraska.
Do they really?
I don't think so. No, I'm thinking that one.
All right, so yes, that I am corrected. Daisy Mayhem in for a back block. And look at that, Postal Penny, number 41 for Dallas, out first for lead jammer. I think that's only the second or third time they've gotten lead jammer. Omaha has been so consistent on the jammer line, but now Midlife Crash is struggling to get through the pack, knocked out by Electra Violet as Postal Penny moves into the pack on a scoring pass. Oh, just avoids a shoulder check from Axel Rogue, bounces off a hip check from Danielle in the coffin, and gets out a grand slam for Dallas. Midlife Crash is, though, completing her initial pass now and chasing down Postal Penny. Postal Penny looking over her shoulder at checking whether she needs to call it off. It gets in there and may. Oh, no. Oh, excuse me. 4 points. That is 4 points for Dallas. I saw the wrong jam rep holding up 0 points. That was to be the Omaha jam rep, but 4 points for Dallas.
You know, Dallas would tell you that their game is very hard and fat. describes their own, self-describes their game as hard and fast, which I think is going to be okay with Omaha. Omaha last previous game against DC seemed to be do a lot better when the pack was moving a lot faster. DC was able to score on them and keep the game pretty close when the game got slower. So I think both of these teams are wanting the pack to move a little faster.
And the pack moving around turn two. That's Rady Ruck getting out for lead jammer, but Rhinestone Caldwell escaping the pack as well. Only about a quarter lap behind. And I believe that's Daisy Mayhem. Yes, Daisy Mayhem coming out of the penalty box. So that's going to even up the odds a little. Actually, it's going to give Omaha a 3-on-2 pack advantage. Dallas with two blockers in the penalty box. Only Chemical Addiction and Mary 8 Ashley on the track. But Rhinestone Call Girl able to get in for two, but Omaha's jammer Rady Ruck picking up four. So 4-2 for Omaha.
And Rhinestone Call Girl's background is actually as a pro bull rider. So I guess she's used to getting hit by people a lot, or by things a lot bigger than any girl in this tournament.
Well, she's definitely used to getting shaken up, I would imagine. I've never ridden a bull before. It is a terrifying prospect to me, I'll be honest.
Not a real one. Maybe a mechanical.
Well, we've got Weapon X, number 666, jamming for Dallas. She gets around Mikilia. At the back of the pack, Skateaway Faye fighting. Oh, nice screen by Texas Viper. Gets her past Postal Penny. But, and Electra Violet almost knocking out of bounds, but on one leg, Skateaway Faye staying in. But now Weapon X is lead jammer and catches Omaha off guard. That was Axel Rogue looking over her shoulder just after Weapon X passes by, as if she felt the breeze, but she completely missed her. All of the Omaha blockers did. And Weapon X getting four, but there's Skateaway Faye catching up and passing. The pack catching up the pack and picking up four as well. Now Weapon X on her second scoring pass, but here comes Skateaway Faye looking to match the points. Now Weapon X did look at her bench and called off the jam just in time and wins the jam by one. A 5-4 jam for Dallas.
It was just a very fast, I was watching the game.
That was a great jam. That was, you know, very exciting. Both jammers getting out and racing away.
You start watching the jammers, and the way they move around. Skateaway Faye with that once again, watching another jammer with that one-legged stay-in. What strikes me is there is yet to be a cutting the track penalty on Omaha, and we've seen so many cutting the track penalties today.
You're a jinx. You're just trying to jinx us. We've got. by us, I mean everyone everyone watching the game. are you disappointed at how many, at how few? I'm just joking.
Kind of horrified at how many there've been in this tournament. So many people trapping each other into.
All right. Well, we've got number 13, Brandy Danger, jamming for Dallas against Midlife Crashes.
Up at the Zombie Burger Jam line.
On the Zombie Burger Jam line. And, of course, our penalty box is sponsored by Notorious R.E.D. And here we go. Brandy Danger getting out just a little bit of help from Chemical Addiction. She is lead jammer for Dallas. Midlife Crashes still in the penalty box. Oh, sorry, still in the pack. The Little Mermaid coming in with a hip check. And Lickety Split Tail backing her up, holding Midlife Crashes at the back of the pack as Brandy Danger moves in for Dallas. She's looking over at the referee, and she did. She got a cutting the track.
And that one's on Dallas. It's not on Omaha.
I can't believe you said that.
I said it was Omaha. Still has not happened. Brandy Danger, of course, coming in third at Speed Nationals 3 years ago. She is one of those straight-ahead skaters.
That's right. Well, Midlife Crashes now on a power jam. Oh, it's an out of play. Yes, out of play on Chemical Addiction of Dallas. That drops them to three blockers on the track on this power kill for Dallas. But it's three blockers on the track for Omaha as well. And now it looks like Juicebox stuck in a little bit of a goat pen, but she's able to get ahead. But Midlife Crashes fighting off the Little Murder Maid and Lickety Split Tail just before Juicebox gets into the mix and gets a 5 for Omaha.
I'd say that was some very good patient jamming out of out of midlife crashes. She sort of just stayed there and waited and watched her hole open up. And as soon as she did, she jumped through it and took it.
This time, Juice Box slowing her down a little bit, but midlife crashes, picking up another grand slam. But just as Brandy Danger comes out, and I believe Brandy Danger on a scoring pass and catches midlife crashes by surprise as she comes out. She's completed her scoring pass. She was on a grand slam, a jammer lap point when she went to the penalty box. So she gets all five on that pass, and now potentially getting another grand slam. She gets past midlife crashes, who was still on the previous scoring pass. Oh, doesn't quite get that last point. Only four. But 9 points after coming out of the penalty box. And I believe she got five before she went to the penalty box. I believe that was a 14-point jam for Dallas. And now it's a 17-point game. Dallas still holding, hugging the belt of Omaha, trying figuratively, of course.
And as we are on a timeout, I see Dirty Larry from Derby for All headed over to fix some equipment on one of the Omaha players. Skates, of course, you've got experienced Derby skaters working at Derby for All, getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. www.derbyforall.com.
All right, well, it looks like a toe stop.
Oh. You don't want those falling off. You forget it's gone, you go to run on it, and that's a face plant.
That's right, that's the nail in the coffin. Her right skate, looks like the toe stop on her right skate is either loose or needs to be replaced. And there's Dirty Larry jumping in and helping out.
Of course, I play with Dirty Larry on your mom men's roller derby, so I know his skill level at fixing skates very well.
All right, well, we are, it looks like we are having an official review, and of course, we'll get you the details as soon as they are available.
Gives me a chance to take a sip of my Derbalife beverage, the Liftoff energy drink. Can keep me going, keep me full of energy for this broadcast. Let's see, of course, Derbalife is the official beverage of the WFTDA Division II tournament announcers.
All right, waiting to see if anything changes. I didn't notice any changes in the penalty box. No changes in the score. And it looks like they're lined up. We have the information coming in, but we may have to fill you in after this next jam. But be assured, we will let you know as soon as we have more information. But right now we have Texas Viper in the penalty box for Omaha. Chemical Addiction standing up in the penalty box for Dallas. So right now 3-on-3 with Rhinestone Call Girl jamming. She's jamming against Rady Rock, and I think we have an update.
Yes, this is Sugar Whip, the Sugar Whips here with the official review. I just got the information, number 665, she's still on the track for Omaha, committed a back block penalty, and that created an advantage. Their jammer still took that hole that was created by the back block, and Dallas had some confusion as to if that gave Omaha an advantage, so they called an official review to get some clarification. All the calls stand.
All right, thank you very much, Sugar Whips. And back to the action, Rhinestone Call Girl.
Working her way to the front, yeah.
Sorry, Rhinestone Call Girl held up by Molly Masker. A long bridge from Omaha. That's Molly Masker, Daisy Mayhem, and Sharon Misery. But Rhinestone Call Girl still going to pick up five for Dallas. Drops it to only 12 points ahead. Cutting the track on Rady Ruck. That sent her to the penalty box.
Now Omaha has had their first cutting the track penalty of the day.
And Texas Viper.
Oh, and Texas Vipers also want a cutting the track. So that's doubling it up. I guess I was jinxed. Oops.
You know what? Honestly, I think it was bound to happen.
I think in this sport, cutting the track penalties, it's like saying,
But right now, Weapon X on the power jam, and a nice spin move takes her right around Axel Rogue just to escape the pack. That was her initial pass. A very dynamic move, an aggressive move up the inside lane. Now on a scoring pass.
Talk about your east-to-west movement. She is just back to forth and back and forth, and that's really how you do it. But again, look at her. She's going back and forth and still really avoiding those edges where she might get backed up and lose some time.
Grand slam for Weapon X of Dallas. Dallas in the black, Omaha in the olive green. And now on her second scoring pass, 5 points in her pocket. Rady Ruck still in the penalty box. Looks like Texas Viper standing up. She's a blocker for Omaha. That will even up the pack to 4-on-4. But Weapon X fighting her way past Danila Yakovin to get out for another grand slam. That's 10 points, and that brings us to a 2-point game. But Rady Ruck released from the penalty box right behind Texas Viper. So now both jammers on the track, but potential points and 4 points for Dallas. That is going to put them in the lead for the first time in the game.
You know, I'm just talking about how young these Omaha jammers are, but for as just being in it for a couple years, they're all showing a tremendous amount of savvy and just knowledge of where to be and beyond their years and experience.
And that is halftime. Dallas pulling it off at the last second, literally.
What I get for not looking at the clock and looking at the game.
But what a first half we've had. It looked like Omaha was just going to run away with it, but Dallas came back. It took them 5 jams, but Dallas got right into their rhythm, and then just a couple of power jams, and Omaha now facing an even match. Maybe they thought they were going to walk away with it, but very exciting first half. I can't imagine what's going to happen in the second.
Oh, I don't know. This is one of those back and forth games. Omaha today has given us the two most exciting games of the day, I'd have to say, so far. I don't know, that Treasure Valley Jet City was pretty great there at the end.
So that's the game
Treasure Valley, but the game right before
DC. The DC World Girls, that's what you were thinking of.
The one before this.
That's right. That one came down to the last jam, and you know what? This first half of this one came down to the last jam for Dallas. But you know what? We're gonna go away for just about 10 minutes or so. But right now it's a 2-point game. Dallas in the lead. And any last thoughts before we take a break?
No, I think we're gonna see some more hard-hitting, fun derby after this.
Thanks for watching.
In the helmet laboratories today, testing some helmets. We are testing soft foam helmets versus hard foam helmets. We have the Lifer Hard Foam CPSC certified on the head form now. We're gonna drop it from the drop tower and we're gonna measure the G-force of the impact. We're gonna take this helmet up 2 meters for its drop. In order to pass this test, this helmet must reduce the energy pulse to under 300 Gs. We hit 186.75 Gs. That's a pass. We've got a soft foam helmet on the head form now. We're going to bring it up to the same distance we did the hard foam helmet and see what happens. As you can see, the soft foam helmet that was dropped from the same distance as the hard.
There we go. Welcome back. We are here at Hy-Vee Hall in Des Moines, Iowa with the WFTDA Division II Championships. Well, not the championship game. This would be one of the consolation games. Decide who goes to the 4-5 game.
The fifth and sixth game. The loser goes to the seventh and eighth seventh, eighth place game. All right, so now that our tongues are untied. It was a very exciting first half. Dallas coming back and getting to 2 points ahead after trailing Omaha by double digits for almost the entire half. So Dallas coming back with a vengeance. Nice comeback for Dallas. Of course, Omaha looking to defend their seeding. Dallas coming in at the ninth seed, and now at this point can finish no less than eighth. That is if they lose both of their next, this game and the next game, but potentially finishing fifth if they win their next two games. Omaha, of course, coming in seventh, can potentially improve by two to fifth place if they win this, but could actually drop down to eighth place if they lose this game and the next game. So those are the stakes right now. We've got number 402, Make It Rain, jamming for Omaha in the olive green, and Anita Wright, number 138, in black for Dallas.
Omaha just has one player over there in the notorious RED penalty box at the beginning of this jam. That would be Molly Massacre sitting over there.
Make it rain quickly up to the front. Brandy Danger, number 13, inverted and leaning in. And Anita Wright comes careening through the pack, slamming, just catching a little bit of the shoulder of Make It Rain, but avoiding an illegal back block. Just kind of a little fortunate, actually stumbling and almost face planting, but she gets the lead jammer, and now she's coming around. Make It Rain held up for two laps in a row by Brandy Danger, and Brandy Danger is not letting up at all. Make It Rain looking frustrated and now gets lapped by Anita Wright of Dallas, who picks up a grand slam. And Brandy Danger now just absolutely immovable until, but she gets a penalty, now going to the penalty box. So that is a little bit of relief for Make It Rain, or I'll bet she's breathing a sigh of relief now. No, not anymore. Going to the penalty box for a back block. So it's going to be a power jam for Dallas, not Texas. Dallas, Texas is a completely different team. Even though they actually only occupy one city, they're still called Texas. But Anita Wright through the pack, second time, grand slam for Dallas. 10 points for the ladies in black.
And that is coming to the end of the jam. Very fast, very penalties. That jammer penalty could the jammer penalties are going to be the story of the game. If they start to, if you start to see that score get one way or the other, you know it's because of the jammer penalties.
Absolutely, those power jams can really take a bite out of a lead or give you one. Dallas at 101, Omaha at 89. That opens up maybe a 12-point lead for Dallas.
Announcer math. You know, you can go. We'd like to thank our sponsor, Printco, PrintcoGraphics.com, for all your printing needs. Hit up PrintcoGraphics.com.
And Weapon X, number 666, fighting off Axel Rogue. She's lead jammer now for Dallas. Dallas is completely in full stride now. They're much more consistently getting lead jammer. Omaha walking all over them the first half.
Omaha giving up a good 5 to 7 feet off of Dallas on the beginning of that power jam. And when you only have to, that letting Weapon X only have to push it lot less, you know, another 5 feet to get them out of play.
But now, right now, in full passive offense formation, aka the sausage, and Brandy Dangerous and Dallas, the entire Dallas blocker squad, spotting Make It Rain coming out of the penalty box, and they stretch it out, forcing Make It Rain to drop back all the way to turn three to come back in. Weapon X coming in, I believe, third scoring pass right now. Calls off the jam just before she gets forced out of bounds. Gets 4 out of a potential 5 points.
Taking the score to Dallas 115, Omaha 89.
That's right, opening up a, what is that? More announcer, we got the 26. Oh, my goodness gracious, 26, thank you very much. Thanks for the assist, Stunt Rocker.
Hey, and if you like what you're seeing here, if you're enjoying these Division II tournaments that we're giving to you, we're putting out here on the WFTDA feed for free, you can support us. Give us a little bit of a tip. Throw it in the jar. Go to the WFTDA.tv/passes and pay what you'd like. Pay us $1, $5, $10, whatever you think this feed is worth. Help us offset some of the costs of giving you this high-quality, high-def feed.
That's right, and don't judge us by our math skills. Now we've got Rhinestone Cowgirl at the front. Molly Massacre holding the line, and look at that. She's just Rhinestone Cowgirl just struggling to get past her. Molly Massacre effortlessly holding her back for 3/4 of a lap, and Rhinestone Cowgirl finally finding a way around Molly Massacre. But at the back of the pack, Rady Ruck, she is lead jammer on a scoring pass, gets knocked out by Postal Penny, but Rhinestone Cowgirl catches up and not going to get any points. Rady Ruck calls it up just in time, but disappointing for Omaha. 2 points, I'm sure.
And if you'd like to tell us how much you think Bulldog here has Glenn Campbell on the brain, you can use the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA on any of the social media services. That's #TalkToWFTDA.
Absolutely. I'm so glad you brought that up, because actually Rhinestone Cowboy was my favorite song in the world from about age 5 to age 10. I wore cowboy boots and everything, but not anymore. don't have cowboy boots anymore. But there is Anita Riott, number 138 for Dallas, in the black. She is lead jammer. And there goes Skate Away Faye in the olive green for Omaha. But a half a lap behind Anita Riott and quickly increasing. A 4 points pass for Anita Riott. But there goes Skate Away Faye into the pack on her first scoring pass, looking to match those 4 points. But Anita Riott sneaking through Omaha, completely knocked to the side. And look at that. Skate Away Faye has to recycle all the way back to turn one. And Anita Riott catches her again. Second time around, Anita Riott looking for the Grand Slam point. Skate Away Faye just looking to match that first scoring pass. But this is potentially a 14th point if Anita Riott gets through. Another five. I believe that's 14 points for Dallas. And Skate Away Faye looking at 4 points. So it's still a plus 10 differential already. Anita Riott goes slamming into Sharon Misery, knocking her down. But it looks like she caught the outside of the shoulder, so no back block. And a 4 for Dallas. So I believe that 18 points to 7 points for Omaha.
And as we are seeing Dallas catch up and now lead in score, you're starting to see Omaha push a little harder and press a little harder, and you're seeing the difference in who has more penalties sort of even up as Omaha is maybe pushing a little harder, getting a little more loosey-goosey and heading to that notorious RED penalty box a lot more.
That's right, and that was actually with a pack disadvantage. Anita Riott picking that up. We've got Rosemary Rockus and Punchy Brewster in the penalty box for Dallas, and Danalia Coffin in the penalty box for Omaha.
Omaha taking this team timeout, trying to calm things down, and we'd like to take a chance to thank Cruise Skate Shop for their sponsorship. CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality tinted derby gear and guidance since 2007. We'd also like to remind you that the tournament MVP's sponsors, Derby for All and Rydell, will be providing the MVPs with a packet with a nice skate package, an MVP winner's package, including Rydell 495s.
All right, that's a nice. I believe that was added in later on in the tournament, just recently today. So that's a nice little addition to the MVP package. Sure. Some lucky skaters will really enjoy that from Rydell. Looks like Midlife Crashes, number 39, jamming for Omaha against number 666 for Dallas Weapon X. 3-on-2 pack advantage for Omaha. Midlife Crashes looking for the outside lane. Now drives to the center, but Electra Violet and Postal Penny are in the way. Now a little push and pull. That's not quite a truck and trailer.
It's close.
And it's not quite Red Rover either, but Weapon X crashes through the pack, and Midlife Crashes X's through the pack. Never mind. But Weapon X hits the pack on her first scoring pass, but Midlife Crashes catches up to her, gets past Weapon X, and Weapon X shuffled off by Nadalia Nikoffin, fresh out of the penalty box. Still one blocker down for each team in the box. So 3-on-3, but Midlife Crashes gets out all 4 points for Omaha and only two for Weapon X of Dallas. So Omaha winning the jam by two.
I believe Weapon X, you could say, was slicing through the pack or clawing her way through the pack.
Or teleporting, I believe, also another
Wolverine
ability.
Wolverine doesn't teleport.
Weapon X.
Weapon X is a Wolverine.
But she's not Wolverine either.
Now we're just confusing everyone with a bunch of comic book geek stuff.
Actually, I have to confess and I apologize to all the geeks out there. I only really know about Weapon X from the movie. So yes, you can scorn me. Please heap scorn upon me. Do not blame Stunt Rocker for anything.
And you can scorn him at the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA.
Well, right now we have Rhinestone Call Girl. She is out of the pack first. She is not lead jammer, though. And Rady Ruck gets out. She is lead jammer, but almost a full lap behind Rhinestone Call Girl. But she opts not to call off the... Well, now, unless I say it out loud, and then she calls off the jam. But not before Rhinestone Call Girl picks up all 4 points.
Grabbing
so 4-0.
Points on that. just zipping around there. Rhinestone Colgirl really coming on in this second half. The second half of the first half as well, as Dallas has taken the lead and is just starting to sort of stretch it slowly out. Omaha just not really getting anything going after that initial burst they had at the beginning.
Absolutely. About 20 minutes in, it looked like Omaha was looking strong, but they seem to have lost their momentum. Dallas all over the game, all over the pack, and now Anita Riot trying to get into the back. Oh, slips right past McKillia. And now weaving her way through, gets a little help from Emergency. McKillia almost catches her in turn three, but Anita Riot escapes and is lead jammer. Make it rain at the front of the pack, still on her initial pass. Jukebox gets in front of her, and Brandy Danger, not able to close the door, though. Make it rain gets up the inside. She is out completing her initial pass, but here comes Anita Riot on a scoring path. Leaps over her fallen teammate, Juicebox. Manages to get back up and not lose too much ground. Calls off the jam before Make It Rain can get in. That's a 2-0 jam for Dallas.
Brandy Danger doing a really good job of sort of playing the middle linebacker with the defense there, holding it together as a wall and holding them down, holding Omaha to no points in that jam.
Yeah, Brandy Danger emerging as a defensive powerhouse for Dallas in the second half.
Appearing to take a real leadership role out on the track.
Absolutely. Very impressed with their play so far. But I mean, I'm really impressed with all of Dallas. And there's Weapon X coming, counter-checking that shoulder check from Sharon Misery and taking out the Omaha blocker. Credit to Sharon Misery, though. She popped right back up and caught up to Weapon X. And Weapon X ran into Daisy Mayhem and forced her to the back of the pack. And there goes Skateaway Faye. Omaha getting their lead jammer for the first time in a while in this second half. Weapon X around the outside, runs into Molly Massacre. Molly Massacre can't get her out, but stays in front of her. Weapon X just barely avoiding a big check from Texas Viper for Omaha. And finally getting out, but Skateaway Faye on a scoring pass. Got into a tangle with the Little Murder Maid, and now Mary 8 Ashley and Electra Violet with a two wall on the outside. They take out Skateaway Faye. Skateaway Faye calls off the jam. 3-0, Weapon X not getting in time.
Skateway Faye just trying to come in there and sneak through as like a little jammer can. She did get tripped up a little bit there on that.
Absolutely, yeah. Skateway Faye had a little trouble getting through that scoring pass. As you can see, didn't get all the points. So Dallas, you know, even though they gave up lead jammer, or really Skateway earned lead jammer, I should say, but they were able to stop her, hold her to only 3 points.
But still, she called it before the Dallas jammer, before Weapon X could get around and get any points. So a 3-0 jam is better than a 4-2 jam.
That's right. Always knowing where the other jammer is, or always being aware, looking around. Brandy Danger comes in, almost knocks some Midlife Crashes. That looked like it was going to be a big hit, but Midlife Crashes able to absorb the blow and stay inbound. But Rhinestone Callgirl, stumbling through the pack, just barely staying on her skates, gets all 5 points for Dallas. Midlife Crashes into the pack on her first scoring pass. Little pile up in turn two, but she's back on her feet. Lickety split tail going to the penalty box. And Daisy Mayhem, that is the nail in the coffin going through the penalty box as well. Rhinestone Cowgirl completing a second scoring pass for another 5 and calls it off.
McKillia there almost taking out short fuse the ref. That wouldn't be good. We don't need that at all.
And Midlife Crashes did pick up 3 points her first scoring pass. But a 10-point jam for Dallas.
Both these teams coming out of the formerly of the hard-hitting Southwest region, or South Central region, whereas Omaha represented the South Central region in Division I regionals last year, and then the North Central division in North Central regionals the year before that. They moved from one to the other.
They've been moving around, but speaking of moving around, there's that for a segue, Bob Knox. Juice Box getting out first. He hasn't jammed in a while. I think this is her first time jamming in the second half, but she gets lead jammer. Rady Ruck, number 777 for Omaha in the olive drab. She is Rady Ruck out of the pack. from her initial pass, but Jukebox dodges around Molly Massacre, and Daisy Mayhem gets 4 points. Bitters Rady Ruck looking to match those points. Rosemary Raucus and Electra Violet hold position. Rosemary Raucus. All these R's. Rosemary Raucus able to get back in front of Rady Ruck. And Electra. I'm questioning myself whether or not I'm supposed to be, Losemary Locus. Sorry about that. Rady Ruck out of the pack, completes her first scoring pass, but she gets lapped by Juicebox, who gets 5 on her second scoring pass. 9 points so far for Dallas, 4 points for Omaha, and now a little defensive jamming from Juicebox, slowing down Rady Ruck. But Rady Ruck gets in, knocked out by Lickety Splittail. But I believe the time ran out, and Dallas coming up with 3. That's up.
Juicebox doing a little of eating the baby there, taking some time off the clock, just keeping the other jammer controlled behind her, eating the time, getting it ahead as they've come out to a nice sized lead.
All right, we've got another Weapon X quickly getting through the pack by turn 2. And Skateaway Faye, zipping right up the center. Mary 8 Ashley was in position but got sent out for a penalty just in a timely fashion for Skateaway Faye. Easy run through the pack for both jammers. Weapon X now gets cleared out by Molly Massacre of Omaha. Skateaway Faye got to the pack but didn't get in. And neither did Weapon X, so it's a scoreless jam for both teams.
Both girls were moving pretty fast, and that reminds me, we need to thank our sponsor, Fast Girl Skates, www.fastgirlskates.com. It's all about you, Fast Girl Skates, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007. As well as Fifth Blocker Skates, fifthblockerskates.co.uk, Scotland's only brick and mortar roller derby store. It's Gallus. That means a wild rascal deserving to be hanged.
That's right, and that is a good description of the owner and proprietor, Marshall Lawless of the Glasgow Roller Derby. And now we've got back on in the action at hand, we've got Rhinestone Call Girl getting around. She is lead jammer. Still in the pack, Make It Rain, number 402, gets shuffled to the inside by Electra Violet. But comes back in. I think she thought that Electra Violet stepped out, but no, Electra Violet clearly stayed in. The referee saw it, and that sends Make It Rain. That was just a little mental error for Omaha. She should have looked back and, should have played it cautious, even if she thought that that the other skater had gone out of bounds.
And that's one of those mistakes that you would expect from the jammers, that they even Omaha would describe as being a little younger, a little greener, a little fresher. You've not seen a lot of those mistakes from the jammers this, so it's quite surprising.
Absolutely. That was a little bit of a surprise, but now it is a power jam for Dallas. Anita Wright held at a standstill, like she is stuck in molasses by the Omaha defense. Danielia Coffin stumbles, and that opens the door for Anita Wright to complete her initial pass. She is lead jammer now. Mary 8 Ashley returning to play, so now Dallas back at full strength. That is Danelia in your coffin going to the penalty box. That's going to drop Omaha down to 3 blockers. Omaha in the green, Dallas in the black, and Anita Riot with 5 points on her first scoring pass.
That trip to the notorious RED penalty box is going to take Danelle in your coffin to 5 penalties, putting her in a bit of penalty trouble. Her as well as Texas Viper are sitting at 5 penalties, getting into that risky area to be ejected from the game when they hit their 7th.
That's right, Omaha with a full penalty box down to 2 blockers on the track. That's Axel Rogue, number 42, and number 2, McKillia. Anita Riot coming around for another scoring pass and breaks through for 5.
what we're looking at here is we've got these. It's not just the passive offense, but they're strung back in that what people would call the sausage formation, keeping the Omaha blockers from coming back and playing behind them, which is a lot nicer way. You've got a lot more room to work with that formation. Now Danielle Coffin is back in, and they're going to keep her as the proverbial goat.
And another five for Dallas, and as it's called off. That brings the score to 195. Now Dallas screaming ahead now. Only 11 minutes left in the game, but Dallas establishing a dominant lead. After trailing in double digits in the entire first half. You always got to remember that, and not only that, but getting seated two places behind Omaha.
Omaha taking this timeout to regroup. Sin City. We'd like to thank our sponsor, Sin City Skates. Oh, now it's gone to review this call. We'd like to thank our sponsor, SinCityskates.com. We don't sell it if we don't play in it. And if you'd like to become, if you've got a business or would like to become a sponsor of the WFTDA, you can go to WFTDA.com/sponsors/opportunities. You can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. When you advertise on WFTDA.tv, we have affordable packages that are rated for your business, boot camp, tournament, or whatever you have ready to go. Also, we'd like to remind you to hit up that Cheeseball Bearings Bracket Bonanza contest down at the bottom of the WFTDA TV screen. Fill that out. There's a lot of prizes for whoever has the best. You can start with the Kalamazoo D2 tournament and then move all the way through the divisional tournaments and the championship.
Indeed. Well, we are working on finding out the information on that official review. But right now the teams are lining up. Make It Rain standing up in the penalty box. Otherwise, the penalty box is empty. So 4-on-4 on the track. Dallas with Jukebox the only jammer on the track to start out with. But, of course, Make It Rain standing up. That means she'll be returning to the track shortly after that first whistle. There it goes. Jukebox leaning in. But Molly Massacre with a shove, leveraging that shoulder. And she actually runs into the hip of Daisy Mayhem, but gets a cutting the track. So Jukebox heading to the box. We come off of a power jam for Dallas and now move into a power jam for Omaha. But now we have some details from Sugar Whips.
Yes, quickly, that official review is because the jammer for Omaha, 402, who is out on the track right now, sat for 2 minutes on insubordination because she did not leave the track for a half of a lap. Omaha challenged it, but the call stands.
Okay, so they were trying to spring the jammer and avoid an extra minute in the penalty box, but right now we've got a power jam for Omaha, so Make It Rain coming around and squeezes past Postal Penny, number 41, and Emergency, number 4NR, and gets out Grand Slam for Omaha.
As she comes back around the track, you'll see that what she's doing is, or what Dallas is doing is they're playing very tight on Omaha. Omaha's trying to take advantage of that, block out and get some room for their jammer. Whereas Omaha, when they're playing on the penalty kill, you're seeing them stay 3 to 5 feet off the pack to try and stop from getting screened out.
And still on the power jam, Brady Ruck lining up for Omaha. Jukebox number 1229 in the penalty box. She is, of course, joined by Lickety Splittail, who went to the penalty box right behind her. So they will be rejoining very close together. But Brandy Danger once again inverted and leaning in. That's Brady Ruck having to push into Brandy Danger's toe stops, but Brandy Danger getting a penalty going to the box. That released Brady Ruck. She's on her first scoring pass now and has in control of the clock with Lee Jammer, gets through for five.
Brandy Danger heading to the penalty box on a out of play penalty, which has been glancing over the penalties that Dallas has had, that has been the majority of their penalties today. They're out of play. She's getting too far off the front of that pack.
All right, but Juicebox making short work of the pack, and you saw that. Yeah, I don't know if you saw that, but brutal shoulder checks from the Dallas Jammer to make her own hole against McKillia of Omaha, number two. But, I didn't catch what the score was in that jam. Okay, sorry about that. It didn't register in my brain. But right now the score 195 for Dallas, 136 for Omaha, with just 8 minutes left in the game.
It's going to take a lot of power jams for Omaha to make up that deficit. It's possible, but we're going to have to see the Dallas Jammers get a lot more sloppy.
Well, that's definitely what Omaha is looking for. Rhinestone cowgirl, a call girl. Rhinestone Call Girl. It is a great song still, though.
But
Rhinestone Call Girl, number 8 for Dallas, going to the penalty box as Jammer. And that means another power jam, back-to-back power jams for Omaha. And a big shoulder check from Midlife Crashes sends the Little Murder Maid onto her back and completes that grand slam for Midlife Crashes. Now once again going against her, but this time the little Murder Maid gets revenge. A hip check sends Midlife Crashes to the ground, and she has to recycle. But no, the Little Murder Maid going to the penalty box. I believe a clockwise block was called, and Midlife Crashes gets another 5-10 points in this jam.
I think that was I don't know if that was an out of play or an out clockwise block. But that was, I am getting told that was an out of play, another out of play for Dallas, and that could be the tail of this second half if something changes. If the score, if Omaha were able to make this up, that would be the story of the game.
Indeed. Well, I saw one of the inside ref, the inside pack ref indicating a clockwise block, but I don't see anyone in the box for a clockwise block. But it may have been overridden by another penalty, but... Or maybe I'm just seeing things. But look at this. Dallas, penalty-wise, just falling apart. They are filling up their box. And Omaha coming on strong, slowly chipping away at this lead. Rhinestone Call Girl colliding with her teammate, Postal Penny. I think that was with a little help from Molly Massacre of Omaha. But
you know, the ebbs and flows of this game have really just been... You could watch the penalty chart the penalties, and watch the ebbs and flows of the score almost match it one for one as one team gets more penalties, they start pushing harder, they get that increases their penalties, then they settle down a bit, and the other team starts getting penalties, they start pushing a little harder.
But look, if you look at the scoreboard, just a couple of jams ago, just two or three jams ago, Dallas was at 195, Omaha was at, I believe, 100, a little over 110, I don't remember the exact score. They've come back to within 35 points, and now we've got a team timeout. Dallas taking the timeout.
Dallas trying to calm their team down a little bit. Midlife, what we're seeing is we've got, once again, Midlife Crashes is just showing how valuable she is to this team. And mostly it's not just with blazing speed or anything, it's just by being a very smart jammer. The last game, she didn't really have any more that many more jams than the rest of the team, but she had almost twice the points of the nearest jammer to her. This game, she's getting a lot more jams, she's getting a lot more points, and just really showing how valuable she can be.
Absolutely, but I just can't take my eyes off of that scoreboard right now. 35 points separating the two teams. Omaha has cut Dallas's lead by half, by more than half.
And with just a hair under 6 minutes left to play, that is not an insurmountable lead.
They are within shooting distance in one good power jam, but potentially.
But one good power jam for Dallas could put it away for them.
That's right. Less than the clock frozen at 5:58 after this team timeout.
Still on a team timeout.
But now, it's converted to an official timeout. The jam timer at the front of the pack indicating it is an official timeout now.
It was just a timeout to confirm the score, Bulldog.
Okay, yeah, well, absolutely. At this point in the game, with just only a few jams left, you definitely do not want to have the score inaccurate.
No, not in a game this important.
Absolutely, and I'm sorry, I'm laughing. Weapon X, that was a
little
peculiar,
dance break.
That was some amazing neck flexibility.
Derby girls on the zombie burger jam line always are going to take a dance break when they can.
And not only flexibility, but that was some flexibility squeezing around the outside of the track. She gets lead jammer less than a second after the whistle. She threw the pack. Skate away face struggling against Anita Wright and Rosemary Raucus at the front of the pack. Finally gets out, but Dallas's jammer, Weapon X, quickly up to the front on her first scoring pass. Gets past McKillia, fights her off, gets all four. Skate away Faye into the pack, but Weapon X looking back at her bench, and her bench saying, no, keep going. The clock is your
friend.
That's absolutely right. The clock is your friend. You want to keep that clock moving. And as long as Omaha is not getting a point differential, then Dallas is perfectly fine continuing with the jam and watching those seconds tick away.
Yes, the situation Dallas is in, two-minute jams are perfectly fine with them.
That's right. All they need to do is keep Omaha from getting a positive differential, and they can just walk away from this game.
Play it clean and keep a positive differential, and that will take that could take Dallas into that 5-6 game tomorrow.
That is right. So now the clock dropping below 5 minutes, and Dallas extending the lead slightly.
We'd like to thank our sponsor, Sin City Skates. The first, the best, happy to fix the rest.
And Postal Penny for Dallas in the black. She is lead jammer. And Make It Rain, number 402 for Omaha, dropping. Has to recycle back and gets lapped by Postal Penny. Postal Penny gets past Texas Viper and Molly Massacre to pick up a grand slam, and that could very well be the nail in the coffin. Not to be confused by the skater for Omaha of a similar name. Postal Penny coming around a second time, squeezes between Molly Massacre and Texas Viper, knocking both of those skaters down, hitting her knees, but popping back up, and now completes her second grand slam of the jam. Make It Rain dropping into a defensive posture and knocks Postal Penny out of bounds, but Postal Penny comes right back in and finds an opening on the outside. Third grand slam, 15 points for Dallas, and time ticking away as well as Omaha's hopes of winning this game.
Omaha is sitting with three of their heaviest hitters with big penalty issues. Where 3:15 left, they've got Texas Viper, Molly Massacre, and Sharon Misery all sitting at five penalties, and those are three key players out there. They can't afford to lose.
And there goes Postal Penny. She got three grand slams the hard way with Omaha's jammer on the track, not a power jam. And Make It Rain just completing her first scoring pass, and Dallas not worried about that at all. They've already got 19 points in their pocket. Postal Penny looking to make it another, get another four on her fifth scoring pass. And here comes Make It Rain approaching for her second scoring pass. But that's not even going to be a threat to Dallas right now. Postal Penny watches her go by and just lets it happen.
Well, Daisy Mayhem opened up a nice little hole there in the back. She screened off just a little subtle screen, not one of the big hits, but opened up that hole. And Dallas seems to be not really caring until it's going to become a big issue with them catching up.
Absolutely, but they're going to need to do something big for Omaha to win this game. Dallas just needs to hold steady, and they've got Lickety Split Tail in the penalty box, number 11 for Dallas. So 4-on-3 pack advantage for Omaha. But there goes Anita Riot jamming for Dallas, dodging back and forth. Sharon Misery, though, holding on and managing to stay in front of a very vigorous attack from Anita Riot. But Rady Ruck stuck in the pack behind the Little Murder Maid. Drops to the inside, gets past her, but runs into Rosemary Raucus. Gets past her, but Anita Riot just escaping in time and clinching lead jammer. And that puts Dallas in control of the clock, which is what Omaha needed to have any chance of even approaching approaching this lead. The only possibility for them was to get a power jam, but Anita Riot calling it off.
Without getting lead jam, Omaha was not going to take control of this. They needed to get lead jam, get some really quick 4-point hit and quit it, maybe get Dallas pushing a little bit. And now as we hit the 1 minute mark, it's really not good. They're going to have hard pressed to try and make up that many points.
Absolutely. Impossible.
We'd also like to thank our sponsors, Rydell Skates. Rydell, a first official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. That's Rydell Skates. Also, Adam Wheels, a proud partner in the official wheel of the WFTDA and the official wheel, the unofficial wheel of me.
But Omaha picking up lead jammer. Midlife crashes, racing through the pack. Weapon X driven to the outside by McKillia. And now getting lapped by Midlife Crashes, who sees a wide open outside lane. The emergency tries to cut her off. Midlife Crashes is going to call off the jam, and they're going to need to call a timeout. And they do. It looks like a team timeout called. Omaha is going to pick up a quick five. And that is put them, well, I'm doing more announcer arithmetic, 51 points. They're going to need a record-breaking. It's a record-breaking jam.
I believe
jam.
That would be a record-breaking jam. I don't remember what that one that Sandrine Rajon had last year, but it's going to be a Herculean effort to try and make that.
But nevertheless, absolutely the right move to even have that possibility. Only 8 seconds left on the clock. Not enough time for Midlife Crashes to make another scoring pass.
Well, they are going to get a full 2 minutes on this new jam.
Absolutely. They had the timeout. Midlife Crashes saw the period clock, called it off just in time. They absolutely did the right thing. And, it's not complete. It's going to take, what did you call it, a Herculean effort.
They're going
to. We get a maybe pronunciation
they're women, so we'll call it an Athenian.
Amazonian.
I was going to say worthy of Athena.
Oh, absolutely. Athena. Absolutely the most awesome goddess. Well,
Artemis,
in the Greek
pantheon. Goddess of the hunt.
Artemis is all right, too. Also called Diana in the Roman pantheon.
But, okay. Thanks for returning to Geek Talk.
Athena, actually one of the few goddesses who is that has the same name in both the Greek and Roman pantheon. Apollo, another one.
There you go. Rady Ruck's going to take the jamming efforts at the Zombie Burger jam line.
Rady Ruck. Oh, Weapon X in the penalty box. I completely missed that. So this is exactly what Omaha needs if they want a chance. But Rady Ruck not to the inside, has to recycle. That puts a kink in the plans. But now weaving her way through, runs into Anita Riott and Brandy Danger, and Rosemary Ruck is coming out of nowhere. But now they're bridging. Rady Ruck gets out, but that was only her initial pass. She's got not scoring yet, but she is lead jammer. And that means that Weapon X is not going to be able to steal the jam away from her by jumping out and getting lead jammer. But that's only the first step. Here's her first scoring pass. Rosemary Ruck is with some hip checks. Anita Riott and Brandy Danger in position. Brandy Danger now in her signature move, but Rady Ruck able to get around the outside.
Anita Riott signaling to her team, don't play so far off, don't give away so much time, just enough that they can't screen you out.
Absolutely. Rady Ruck now on her second scoring pass. Oh, gets a hip check from Rosemary Ruckus that knocks her to her knees. Picks herself back up quickly, though, now running into Anita Riott and Brandy Danger. Period clock obviously has expired, so this is the final jam. Anita Riott sent to the penalty box, but Weapon X out of the penalty box, and that pretty much spells doom because Weapon X can now, and Rady Ruck sees that, and there wasn't really enough time on the jam clock to get more than a couple more passes anyway. Rady Ruck calling off the jam, and that ends it.
Our top jammers today, Midlife Crashes had 30 points. Anita Riott had 24 Dallas, and Midlife Crashes having those 20 for Omaha, or those 30 for Omaha, not quite getting up to her total of the game earlier today against DC, but still having a great game. Hard to believe that Midlife Crashes just got brought up from the B team. She plays and acts like so much, just like someone who's been playing this game her whole life. Great track awareness, great derby awareness.
Thank you for having us. For this ballot, we've got one more round coming up this evening at 8 o'clock featuring.
A different voice.
All right, but a tremendous game by Dallas. If you were watching in the first half, they were trailing by double digits. I said it a couple times before, but I'll repeat myself all day long if you let me. Dallas trailing by double digits almost the entire half, just coming back in the last jam to win the first half by two, and then just took off, and Omaha was sent spinning and never really recovered.
Right. Omaha just got themselves into foul trouble early in that second half, and the score just went way up. And if you'll look out there, if we can switch back to the screen, we're seeing the Dallas players making a giant bridge of hands.
That's the London
for the
Bridge.
Omaha, the London Bridge for the Omaha players, showing them great respect and great derby love.
That's right. That's actually a formation that was popularized by the London Roller Girls when they came over here on a trip in the Northwest where they started doing that, and it's really caught on. It's a gesture of respect for the opposing team for a great game played.
Well, and it reminds you that as much as this becomes this sport grows and becomes bigger and bigger and more of a mainstream sport, if you will, it's still about this. There's still that element of sisterhood and love and just derby love that we're all here for.
All right. Yes, indeed. Absolutely. And, the results of that game sends Dallas into the fifth-place game. They potentially are going to improve by four positions. And that sends Omaha, they're disappointed, but potentially able to. Now they're just going to be left to defend their original seeding. They're going to be playing in the seventh-place game after being seeded seventh from the beginning.
Omaha is, yes, they're going to be able to play to defend their seed, to match their seed, and they get another game. That's the bottom line.
Absolutely. Thank our sponsors, definitely. You want to run them off?
Well, I'd like to also, once again, thank Derby for All. Derby for All has been the skate tech. Dirty Larry over there has been the skate tech for the whole tournament, fixing people's skates, keeping them on the track, keeping them playing as they're going. You can find them at www.derbyforall.com. They've got a whole crew of experienced derby skaters getting you the right gear to get you to the next level, and I can personally attest that they know their stuff.
And big thanks to Derba Life as well. As you can see, they've got their the lift off
energy drink
energy
keeping
drink.
Us going on this long
All of a sudden, I can't
tournament.
Think of words to say.
This long tournament. They are the official drink of the announcers this weekend.
That is correct. And also, you can support WFTD.TV. You're getting this broadcast live, but you can please feel if you feel the urge, donate. You got just click the button.
Keep us going.
Oh, and we're warming up right now. Duke City. They're going to be playing against the Brew City Bruisers. That's coming up next, and that is going to determine who is going to face Dallas in the fifth place game, and who is going to face Omaha in the seventh place game.
That's going to sort of fill out your bracket for tomorrow. So make sure you stick around for that game. We're going to have a lot of fun action. I think that'll be a really good one.
All right, and that is it. We're going to sign off for the next. Time you tune in, you're going to be seeing Brew City versus Duke City. Thank you very much for tuning in.
Stay calm.
See the space.
And believe in your blockers. I know I trust my training. Do you? Get some athletics.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.